Hello and good evening, everyone, and welcome to our Formula 1 2021 of my team J-Po Career Mode. And this is episode number 112, and we're at the Baku City Circuit for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And this is episode number 112 in our sixth season of our Formula 1 My Team J-Po Career Mode. If you missed the previous Formula 1 race, it was the Crown Jewel Edition. It was the Monaco Grand Prix, episode number 111. Be sure to check it out on twitch.tv/feedchampionator3. And also, if you want to check it on YouTube.com, you can do so at YouTube.com/speedchampionator3. And if you wanted to donate and to make a charity of my channel, and then also click on the link and subscribe to my channel as well, be sure to do so at Twitch.tv/speedchampionator3. And if you want to go to YouTube.com, you can do that, and then also go to subscribe to my channel on the red bell on your right and subscribe to youtube.com/speedchampionator3. Well, it was a pretty rough race in the previous one in the Monaco Grand Prix. It was pretty rough out there, but it took us about 11 times of hitting all those cars in each other, and then we had to use all five flashbacks. And it wasn't really much of a good performance there. It was a fair performance, and we started from 18th in the race, and then we made it all the way up into podium finish to finish up in P3 with the 3-second penalty. But we had enough margin and enough advantage to go all the way to the distance of 78 laps, and then and George Russell, for the second year in a row, got his second win of the season when he had a much-needed win, and then goes back in contention for the Formula One World Championship. And we have done a great job in practice. In all three practice sessions, we have been the fastest. In all three, practice one, set two, and we have been a minute 38 seconds here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And hopefully we could do well here if we get a good chance and a good shot of winning this race and rebound from our previous Formula One race. We haven't been worse than about third position in the podium. So we're getting ready to qualify here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix for episode number 112 in our sixth season of our Formula One My Team J-Po Career Mode. Here it is. So we can have a better qualifying effort than we did in Monaco. We should have qualified in the top 10 if we needed to. Now we're going into this very long straightaway. This is the longest set straightaway here in Formula One. Now we're P11. We just didn't get a chance to qualify that fast. We're going to have to take another lap here, so that way we don't start way over in the back of the field again. Ah, damn it. I hit the wall going in there. I just went a little bit too quick. And now I hit the wall on the other side. I'm going to have to go to the garage and repair the wing. I don't think this is enough right here, though. We're 6 seconds off the pace.
Car repairs have set us back a little so far. Our fastest lap is a 1:39.4.
Let's see if it is enough. George Russell is on pole position with 1:38. And it is enough, yes. So we made it into the second qualifying session because we had wing damage on the car. Yeah, we got to qualify good. You know, we need to have a better qualifying. If we don't have a better qualifying, then we're not going to make it. This is a great time right there. We're already in the two sectors so far. We're still purple. We could be able to get pole position. And it is 1:38.742. And that's exactly what we needed. We're right on the top spot. A much better qualifying than it is in a long while. 1:38.742. And that's going to put us into P3 because George Russell just took another lap and he is at 1:38.590. We need to be faster than George Russell with 1:38.590. If we are, then we'll be in good shape to get that pole position. And we made it into the third qualifying session beautifully. And that's what we needed. Man, we don't know what's going on with Lewis Hamilton over here. Where is he? Lundgaard and everybody else. Well, he had no time. It looks like he had problems with the car. It looks like he blown the motor, so that means he had no time on the car, so he had to start in P16. What a tough break. And we see McLaren, Stroll. Look at this. The Aston Martin cars, the 7th and 8th. They're going to do a good job here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. That was a great qualifying. That's the first time we ever made it to the third qualifying session since the Portuguese Grand Prix. Okay, can we try to beat out our teammate George Russell with the minute 38.570? The second lap is going to be the fastest. Position. This lap is looking pretty good. This is a very good lap here. Very good lap at the Baku City Circuit. Are we going to get pole position here at Azerbaijan? And it is. Win at 38.499. It is pole position. But is it going to stand? That was the fastest lap that we ever gotten here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. But George Russell, George Russell got it.
With qualifying finished,
and Pierre Gasly got it.
Top three, Gasly, Russell, and Hawk.
So we ended up in P3. Pierre Gasly is on the pole for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix with a minute 38.165. We were only three car lengths slower, and George Russell and I are now starting second and third. And Max Verstappen fourth, Lando Norris fifth, Bottas, Leclerc, and then Giovinazzi and Stroll in eighth and ninth, and then Daniel Ricciardo goes into the top 10. That was a nice qualifying. We gave it our best effort, but then Pierre Gasly just had the upper notch again.
All right, I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
And anyway, that was a great qualifying, and we rebounded from the last two races that we had to start in the first round of qualifying, and now we made it in to all three rounds of qualifying, and we are ready to go, and we're going to start on the inside of row two. Let's see if we can have a very good race, a very good, clean, and safe, and perfect race here at the Baku City Circuit for episode number 112 of our Formula One My Team J-Bo Career Mode. And then during the race, it's going to be sunny to start with, but then clouds are going to be rolling in, but no rain is going to be effective for this race. So let's see if we can try to come away with the win and then try to rebound a little bit after third-place podium finishes in the last two races at the Spanish Grand Prix and the Monaco Grand Prix. We got a new gearbox on this car, and we are ready to go. Episode number 112, here is the Azerbaijan Grand Prix at the Baku City Circuit.
A warm welcome to all of you watching at home to today's Azerbaijan Grand Prix, and a race that in its short history has already proven no stranger to drama. A fourth row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as a pole position would. And remember, in 2017 and 2018, both Lance Stroll and then Sergio Perez took surprise podiums here. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit at the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through sector 3 towards the finish line. And with me as usual is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Hawk. That was a great podium in the last race. So can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out will have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. A fantastic effort from Pierre Gasly yesterday puts him on pole, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hawk, Verstappen, Lando Norris, and Bottas, Leclerc, Giovinazzi, Stroll, and Daniel Ricciardo, Sainz, Lundgaard, Yuki Tsunoda and Matsushita, Ocon, Hamilton, Nicholas Latifi and Mick Schumacher, Islands, Schwartzman, Joe and Nikita Mazepin. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Alright, let's take a look at the race direction and see if anybody's going to go with the medium tire strategy, and it looks like none of them are going to go with the medium tire strategy. They're all going full tilt on the softs. Now the race strategy, well, now we can go the first 15 laps under the soft tires, and then after that we can put on the medium tires for the next for the next 20 laps, and then the next 21 laps in the final stint on the medium tires. And this race will last for an hour and 24 minutes, and we could do this on a two-fire tire pit stop, and then put 51 laps into the record books here at the Baku City Circuit. We've had three third-place podiums at the Spanish Grand Prix and the Monaco Grand Prix, and then George Russell won the previous race, and he won his second race of the season. See if we can try to get up back on top with the Team Toxic JPO, because remember, Team Toxic JPO did win Monaco. That was the third time. That was only the second time as an owner-driver that I won the Monaco Grand Prix as an owner, and George Russell won it for two seasons in a row. But now we move on into the Azerbaijan Grand Prix for episode number 112. Let's see if my boss for myself can get back on top. Let's get ready to run our formation lap here at Baku. And Pierre Gasly might be in a lot of pressure with the toxic J-post because he doesn't have his teammate Lewis Hamilton right up ahead of him. Issue between the both of us. Is gridded on here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix for episode number 112. Five red lights come on here for Azerbaijan Grand Prix at Baku City Circuit. And we're underway. That's a good start for us, but we're starting like a drag race right in between me and Gasly. But I got the advantage over George Russell and I move up into P2. Oh, looks like we got a caution. Closing the gap on Gasly, I have a good car. Oh. there's something wrong with George Russell's car. Gasly seems to have good pace going into the long straightaway, but I have good pace going into the turn. And we see one car that is now into the pits. It just made a wing change. It looks like that's one of the Williams. Gasly are just running all by ourselves right now. Make sure we don't ram into them. This is a nice start so far. This is what we needed here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. A great start. We're closing in on Gasly, but look at Russell. He is fast going into this long straightaway. But we got the fastest lap with 1:42.400. Keep this up. It's DRS time, and Pierre Gasly is going to be under a lot of pressure. We're not going to pass him here. Yeah, we're not going to pass him here. We're going to wait until we go to the long straightaway to get the advantage. Ooh, man, almost ran into him too. He's going to have DRS, and so is Max Verstappen. Oh, damn it. Oh, darn it. Oh, man. George, I would have a little hesitated too much right there. Lewis Hamilton, he has been having a rough day. He's been having a rough week here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And I move back up into second place. And Lewis Hamilton gets an early out. It looks like he crashed going into the straightaway. And I rammed into George Russell because I hesitated a little bit. I hope that'll be the only mistake in the race. Come on, I don't want to make any more mistakes here like I did in Monaco. Remember, Lewis Hamilton blew an engine during the... It looks like he should have changed his engine during the qualifying session. He could have started dead last in this race and he hesitated. Contact with Hamilton. Of 51 laps so far. For Stappen and Russell. down to three car lengths right now, but we have to be careful. Getting into that dirty air, it's really just slipping the car a little bit. Yes. We still cannot pass them. Yeah, we're right on the nose of it. Right there. I will have enough on length for the DRS. Here we go. I'm going to be right on the nose of Pierre Gasly. Will be good enough to pass him. Here we go. Can we get the lead? And it looks like we're going to get the lead. Yes, we do. What a nice job. Well, it took us about nine laps to take the lead here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Now Pierre Gasly is going to have the DRS. No, he's going to the pits. Lando Norris that had the wing damage. I running a 4.7 advantage over our teammate George Russell. He's still running in second place. He just got around Bottas. Consistent racing so far for me and George Russell, running 1-2, Lundgaard is third, Sainz fourth, and Tsunoda rounds up the top five. Alright, teammate Russell goes into the pits, and we are going to go as well after this lap. We're 17 seconds now ahead of Pierre Gasly. He did take the soft tire.
We're leading our teammate by 8.1 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in 7th.
I don't know why Gasly had to take the... come into the pits, but we are going to go with the medium tires. So we're going to go with the medium tires. Because it looks to be Bottas took the medium, so we're going to take it as well. And now Tsunoda goes into the pits. And we're right behind Pierre Gasly. Thank you. we're not cutting the corner there. We're right behind Gasly. This is another battle for the lead again. So we're glad we were able to get second place out of that after that pit stop. Look at this. Russell went with mediums, and I went with mediums, and so did Leclerc. Gasly is doing very well on those tires. I think those are the used up tires. We're going to be able to pass them again right on the same corner. That was a nice pass again, and we take the lead once again here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Oh, almost hit the wall there. Gasly's got those used up soft tires, and they're not working very well for him. Looks to me the medium tires was the tire of choice, and they're running a much more faster than the soft tires. After 15 or 51 laps, and the medium tires are working a big advantage over Pierre Gasly, and we're already 1.3 seconds. We're also going away from Max Verstappen, and Verstappen is closing in on Gasly. Now remember, those two guys have to stop early, and this was the right tire of choice. We are pulling away from Pierre Gasly. The medium tires are working. Well, that's what you get, Gasly, for putting on your worn soft tires. You should have went with mediums anyway. And it would have made some competitive racing, but and the same goes with Max Verstappen. And I don't know why these two had to go, that tire setup, and they took too much of a gamble, and they're losing ground over me. I'm 5.4 seconds now ahead of George Russell for fourth place, and I got the fastest lap at a minute 41.694. Great lap so far. Glad the Toxic Attractions have retained their titles after a week ago when they lost them, but it was short-lived for Dakota Kai and Michelle Gonzalez. But we're doing a magnificent job here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. business moving around these corners here at this street fighting circuit at the Baku City Circuit, and we're pulling away with Pierre Gasly under 2.1 seconds. Seconds now, we are pulling the gap away from Pierre Gasly for second place. It's going to be 1-2 for the Team Toxic Zephyr once Gasly and Verstappen go into the pits. And I think probably Leclerc will be going into third place as well. Window is going to be on lap 31. Another great lap, 141.689. Lapping a minute 41.523. We're still flying here at Baku. And there goes there's the pit stop right now for Pierre Gasly and Max Verstappen, and they're going to lose a lot of track position. And that moves George Russell, and it's now 1-2 for the Team Toxic Depot. And the Ferraris are now third and fifth. Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz. And Lando Norris is in fourth place in the McLaren. Tough break for Gasly and Verstappen. And it looks like they're going to have to go with medium, but we made the right move to go with the medium tires. Got a 6.5 second advantage over George Russell. It's 1-2 right now for the team Toxic Depot. It looks to be a Toxic City circuit here in Baku. And we're about to reach the 20th lap here. We're 5 laps until the halfway point of this Azerbaijan Grand Prix, episode number 112. Remaining here in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. We're having a good, comfortable lead so far. We're pulling away from our teammate, George Russell. He's still running in second. And he has a good advantage now over Charles Leclerc, who's in third place, but he has got Lando Norris getting under pressure against him. Lando Norris is running in fourth. It's two Mercedes, and then the Ferrari. Then we have another Mercedes, and Ferrari running in fifth. So totally focused coming into this race today. Things didn't work out well with the NASCAR 21 career mode because Michigan is one of the worst tracks in the NASCAR calendar. I'm glad I don't have to restart the session and all in the multiple goes. They gotta fix that track. Why can't they make it look like Formula One? You know, Formula One I can do a lot better. Norris really desperately wants to get that podium position away from Leclerc. He's right on the nose, trying to get P3. I think in sixth, running in sixth right now is, I think, Giovinazzi or Stroll. Pierre Gasly firmly runs in P7. And our last pit stop is going to be on lap 31. It could be extended to maybe lap 34. And there's the strategy. It looks to be that we're going to expand to lap 34, and I said it correctly, that we're going to be pitting on lap 34 at the back here at Azerbaijan. So the medium tires have now been extended. Still trying to be patient out there, trying to see if he could lurk around Charles Leclerc to P3. They're running right close together. Sainz is not far behind. Pierre Gasly's coming into the pits again. Does he have wing damage? It looks to be he has wing damage on his car. What a tough break for Pierre Gasly. It looks like he tried to pass somebody and then now he has wing damage. And that's really got him out of the strategy now. And he's well out of contention here in the Baku City Circuit. He started in second place and now he has dropped into way back in position. Now he's right behind all the back markers in the field. Halfway point, 25 of 51 laps. 10 seconds ahead of our teammate, George Russell. It's going to be the fastest lap, and it is. Minute 31.388. Seconds now, George Russell. We are so much flying here in Baku. I'm glad to pick this library paint scheme. I really love this paint scheme as well. And the first time I used that, the sunset halo on the front of the paint scheme. That's one of the new Podium Pass halo paint scheme. I always love the sunset in the ocean. Now goes into the pits on lap 28. He'll make his final pit stop by putting on the final set of medium tires. And Max Verstappen has got the fastest lap in the minute 41, going 198. He won't finish till lap 34. Superior Racing so far at the Baku City Circuit, 12-second lead. And it still continues to be 1-2 for Team Toxic Depot, and we have a fault on the DRS lane. Looks to be that Gia Venanzi made it into the pit, and now Max Verstappen is now running into P5. Well, Max Verstappen just got passed around Gia Venanzi, and he moves up into fifth. Down the line on lap 30, we have 22 laps remaining in here in Baku. By the way, another impressive performance race at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Now goes Mick to his final pit stop on lap 31. We pit on lap 34. Looks like me and Russell are going to stay to maintain our positions for first and second after our final pit stop. Sainz now goes into the pit. Like Lance Stroll is down fastest after 32 or 51, we're 2 laps away, making a pit stop, and it'll be our final one of the race at Azerbaijan, leading by 11 seconds of our teammate George Russell. Still 1-2 for Team Toxic Depot. We're really toxic it up right here at Azerbaijan. And we know that my teammate Russell is going to be pitting on this lap. Sitting on lap 33. He does pit.
George is in the pits. George in the pits.
Pit window right now, after 34 or 51 laps, we're going to come in. It's very surprising at this big street circuit track, and we have no cars on the lead, no cars a lap down yet. Pit stop one last time. An hour and 22 minutes into the race, and we should be able to get this over. within about 17 laps to go in our final pit stop. Nice pit stop that was, 2.0 seconds.
Look after these tires now. We have finished the race on this car.
Is going to cloud up or no rain in sight. Back to stop and now into the pits on lap 36. See where he's going to end up. see what this time will be on lap 38. It's going to be a lot faster, and it is. A minute 40.749. Seconds. We're still pulling away from our teammate George Russell. This could be our second 1-2 finish of the season. Remember, our last 1-2 finish was at the season opener in Bahrain, and it could be our second one of the season at Azerbaijan. The next race here in Formula 1 will be the Canadian Grand Prix, episode number 113 at Circuit Yellowstone. That will be our next episode. Coming down the line on lap 40, this will be 12 laps remaining in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. We're on our way to trying to win our fourth race of the season. Now it's 1-2 for the Team Toxic Lethal Mercedes, and then 3-4 for the Scuderia Ferraris. Ferraris are doing a great job. Leclerc is third, Sainz fourth. The next season's Formula 1 2022, and it looks like Ferrari is going to have the upper hand. They're going to be way better. Ferrari and Honda will be having the upper hand this season. When the 2022 game comes out, and Leclerc and Sainz are going to be in the high driver range, and so is Verstappen. And this is a fantastic race that I've had in a long while here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. We're in the closing stages. We're just about 10 laps remaining. 10 and a half laps to go. And Baku leading the race. George Russell second. Toxic Attraction can hold all the gold. We can sweep the podium. 1-2 right here for the second time this season. If it will stand that way. All that Russell has to do is just stay out there for 10 laps, and then our 1-2 finish will be ours. AC on leading, going into the longest straightaway here in the Formula One calendar. There's Russell in second, and there's the two red-blooded Ferraris, third and fourth, running together. And Fleischer seems to be closing in on Charles Leclerc. They're running in the perfect unit so far. And then we got Verstappen running in fifth, and then Giovinazzi having a great race today, running in sixth place. Norris is in seventh, Tsunoda eighth. Pierre Gasly runs in ninth, and then he's quite behind Daniel Ricciardo running in tenth. What a comeback by Pierre Gasly. Oh my goodness, how close can you get here at Baku? Nine and a half miles remaining, and I almost made contact with the wall a couple of times. Guys, so much for giving me a very fast car right here once again at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. After 45 with 51 laps. Well, 44 with 51 laps actually. Got about 8 laps remaining in Baku. Well, it looks like something's wrong looks like one of the cars just made a pit stop there. It looks like that's Nobuhalo Matsushita, who now has the soft tires. He made a pit stop. think it's going to be pretty quick right now with those soft tires, but he has dropped well back in the field. Here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, coming down the line after 46 of 51 laps, we've got about 6 laps remaining. Still 1-2 for the Team Toxic Depot, looking for our second one of the season. And that little car right behind me is Nobuhiro Masashita. He's a lap down. He's the first car one lap down. He's in 20th position after making a pit stop. It looks like he had front wing damage. We're going to take a look at that race direction. And also a tough race for Pierre Gasly, who also had wing damage during the mid part of the race, but he has already moved forward, and he's in, I think he's P11 right now. Time in qualifying, he had engine trouble, and then the engine expired on him on lap 6. seems to be gaining on my teammate George Russell. He's only about 3.5 seconds behind Russell for P2. And it seems to look that way too. And Russell is right there, 13 seconds, and there is the two Ferraris of McLaren and Sainz. They're closing in on George Russell for P2. Russell trying to hold off a 3.2 second advantage, so he is gaining on my teammate George Russell to go for second place. Great day so far for the Scuderia Ferrari. To go in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, looking for our fourth win of the season for the Team Toxic Depot. They've already won 5 races in a row. The only time that we didn't win was at the Spanish Grand Prix. Pierre Gasly won that one. And then the previous race in Monaco, George Russell won that one. Won that one, and then Pierre Gasly was in 6th place. And then hometown hero Charles Leclerc, in the previous race, finished his runner-up finish at his home track in Monaco. We got about 2.5 laps remaining in the Baku City Circuit. We have ran a terrific race. So far, we only made one miscue mistake, and that was the contact between me and George Russell. There's 2.5 laps remaining. We're making it home, winning here at the Baku City Circuit. 13 seconds now ahead. To get the DRS wing fixed. It's a little bit too late for traffic. We already caught up with the back marker traffic now. It took us 50 laps to run the entire way with the back marker traffic. Going to be the fastest lap here, and we're going to make it count for the next lap. It's the final lap here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. One last time around in the Baku City Circuit and going for our fourth win of the season and second 1-2 finish here in Azerbaijan. And this next time around, the final lap of this Azerbaijan Grand Prix, one more to go.
This is your final lap of the race.
It was a great time to get that fastest lap, minute and 40.127. Seems to be that George Russell, my teammate, is going to hold on into P2 over the Scuderia Ferraris, and they're both running together. And Sainz could be able to have a podium finish and try to steal this away from Charles Leclerc. Final time around in the long front straightaway here in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. We have ran a terrific, beautiful race. And I told you we were going to have a beautiful race, and we sure did. No mistakes at all. We won this Q during the beginning of the race. I ran into my teammate George Russell, and we are going to win the Azerbaijan Grand Prix, fourth win of the season. Toxic up, baby. And most certainly, what a great job for Carlos Sainz. Driver of the day, and he gets a P4 finish. Well, I'm glad that winner's circle of listening victory lane that works again.
Excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium.
Toxic Galactic sweeps it up here at the Baku City Circuit. What a good job for me and George Russell. We both had a tremendous day in the Baku City Circuit of winning the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. I don't know how many times I've won the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. I think that's the 40th time. Tremendous job and a tremendous race and a 1-2 sweep for the Team Toxic J-Pro. And we both hold world in the 1-2 finish for the second time this season. And the Ferrari gets a 3-4 finish here today at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Great racing for Charles Leclerc. He gets a podium, and then Carlos Sainz gets the driver of the day. Max Verstappen gets a top five. Great race for Antonio Giovinazzi. And he was the sleeper of the race, and he gets a P6. Daniel Ricciardo 7, Tony Tsunoda did a great job, 8, Lando Norris 9th, and then Pierre Gasly, who had wing damage on his car, but he still holds on to get that one important points position for the Mercedes and finishes in the top 10. Not a bad race for Mick Schumacher. He started 18th, and look at that, he got 13th. A good day for the Haas team, for Mick Schumacher. Let's take a look at the race direction about the incident. Well, Lewis Hamilton on lap 3 had a mechanical failure. And Schwartzman and Norris got wing damage, but I can't believe Lando Norris finished in P5 in this entire race. Well, I think he finished in P6. But there were three cars that had front wing damage. Pierre Gasly on lap 24 had front wing damage. It looks like he rammed into Schwartzman. Then Lundgaard, Stroll, and Masashita had wing damage. And so did Bottas on lap 31. He had wing damage. And then Bottas again. That's the second time he had wing damage. Win. What a tough day for Valtteri Bottas. And you can see why he was way back in the field. He went into 21st position. So that wasn't Masashita. That was Bottas, who had two wing damages. And it was the only car that was a lap down. And Marvin Schwartzman finished in 18th, and Lundgaard got well back on the order. But a good day for Mick Schumacher. He did a very good job out there. And Lando Norris recovered to finish in 9th. Well, let's take a look at the highlights of the race. What a very impressive performance and a great episode for episode number 112 here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. 1-2 finish for Team Toxic J-Po. Started in P3, and then I ran right in the outside of my teammate, George Russell. Both of them all in one go, passing around Verstappen and Russell. Comes to pass on lap 14. This is where I got around Pierre Gasly and lead the race and lead it for good. Final lap of the race, I just had a commanding lead throughout there, and a 1-2 finish. And look at this, there's George Russell coming right into the front straightaway. I mean, he wasn't really far behind. He was only about 14 seconds. And then Charles Leclerc kind of finishes in third. He was about 3.8 seconds ahead of which Russell was. And then Carlos Sainz 1 second ahead. And Max Verstappen in the top 5. Great racing and great win here in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Let's take a look at the standings. We have 150 points now and 58 ahead of Pierre Gasly. As we take the commanding lead once again. And then George Russell is still catching up with 77 points. He still stands in third. Verstappen fourth. And Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz were the big movers. They finished 5th and 6th place. Bottas 7th, Tsunoda 8th, Masashita 9th, and Daniel Ricciardo rounds out the top 10.
Amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. Your team dominated the race today. Was it the car or the teamwork? What's the secret to your success?
We had a great car, and they cured the handling, and they did a pretty good job, and I'm glad to have my fourth win of the season, and we're still at each podium in the last seven races, and the car was absolutely perfect. It was a 1-2 finish between Toxic Capo, and hats off to the team, and they did that very nicely, very calmly and smoothly, and we came out victorious in Azerbaijan. It was a great race.
Well, looks like your luck has changed. Things went a lot better than last weekend, didn't they?
It most certainly was a whole lot better than it was in the Monaco Grand Prix. Monaco, we kept hitting the walls too much or anything. It looks like we went a little bit too fast, a little bit too impatient over there, but we'll try to get some adjustments out of that for next season's final season of that, my team, Jaber Career Mode. But it's really paid off today, and we got our fourth win of the season. Great job. An amazing job for me and Russell. We both had a great day.
You're beating all expectations. Would you say we all underestimated you?
Yeah, it was fantastic out there. Great showing and a great car. Everything went our way today, and we had a perfect race. And then in the next race at Circuit Gillespie, the Canadian Grand Prix, we expect to have the same results.
Interesting result today. Would you say that you're happy with your performance?
I tremendously am. Superior job.
Great. Well, that's everything.
Well, still beating our rivalry, Max Verstappen, who finished in P5 at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And this will give us a great question coming into the next one when we go to the Canadian Grand Prix at Circuit Gillespie. Sure, we have all the cash in the world, $209 million. Getting close to our way of being a billionaire. Pretending to be.
Morning, boss. This week's income from the sponsors is clear, and we're making good profit against our running costs.
And now we're going to be tremendously rebuilding the sponsors, so we're going to have three new sponsors coming into the car. I think we're going to pick that one. That sponsor, the German sponsor, the Sylvain sponsor, and the TriStar sponsor for the next race coming into the Canadian Grand Prix. And we now have 150 points to be comfortable on. The lowest position we had was third place, and we finished all podium finishes in the last seven races. And then starting in the Canadian Grand Prix, we are going to run our last race for the first spec engine. And the first spec engine is still running good, 35%, 43%. So most certainly that will be our last race for the first spec engine after eight races. And then on race 9 in the French Grand Prix, in episode number 114, we will change everything. Everything will be changed coming into the next one when we go to... In the next two races, when we go to the French Grand Prix at Le Cascade Circuit. And I think we're possibly doing aero team building coming into the next one in the Canadian Grand Prix for episode number 113. So what a great race it was in the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Perfect race, less mistakes. And we did the awesome out there. The car was absolutely perfect. 1-2 finish and the second time this season. And I hope it keeps us and gives us our momentum of coming into the next one in the Canadian Grand Prix. We expect to have a very good result. So there you have it. That will end our coverage here for our Speed Generator 3 channel. And thank you so much for watching a great race here at the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. And we came out 1-2 finish for me and Russell. And thank you so much for watching here on the Speed Generator 3 channel. And hope everybody has a good night and everything. Let's hope they have the race in Martinsville tonight. I don't know if it's not as postponed or anything else, but I know the Cup Series will be tomorrow, and we might do another rally race tomorrow for the Portuguese rally. But thanks everyone for watching. I hope everybody has a good night and get some rest and take care everyone, and we'll see you into the next one. So long, good night.